People deal with anxiety in different ways. Some people stress clean. Some people stress shop. And when it comes to our climate anxiety, well, we've been stress planting.
Officials in Ethiopia say a new record has been set with more than 200 million trees planted in just one day.
Today, we will be planting 20 million trees.
Who's against the trees? I mean, the tree, everyone's for the trees.
For 23-year-old Quebecer Antoine Moses broke the world record for the amount of trees planted.
Important people around the world agreed and decreed that planting trees is a great path towards climate redemption.
We can get real on coal, cars, cash, and trees.
But as we start to realize how problematic tree planting programs can be, is this path truly as redeeming as we thought? The idea of planting trees to solve the climate crisis has taken off in recent years. Everyone and their mother are behind it. Seriously, my mum loves planting trees. It's funny because my mum is actually known, like, in the local area we grew up for as a tree planter, like a controversial tree planter. Okay. In the 2019 UK general election, parties fought over who can outplant one another. It makes everyone look good. The logic is clear. Trees absorb a lot of carbon. The bigger the tree gets, the more of it there is, and the more carbon is absorbed from the air. Exactly what we need. It's hard to pinpoint what started this craze. Some say it was the 2011 Bonn Challenge.
The largest restoration initiative the world has ever known.
Others chalk it up to the controversial 2019 paper, which argued that planting trees is our most effective climate solution to date. This was picked up by almost 600 media outlets and inspired all sorts of mass initiatives. And here we are today, in a world where climate solutions are extremely complicated and technical, the simplicity of putting a tree in the ground is refreshing and reassuring.
A breakthrough in the fight against pollution and dirt, the inimitable, unique, irreplaceable tree.
But it's also the reason why we've taken this solution a little bit too far.
If the idea that you can simply invest a little money and make your carbon footprint disappear sounds too good to be true, that's because it absolutely is.
And in our quest to meet demand from individuals, governments, and corporations, we're disregarding the complicated nature of our forest ecosystem. And this can be hugely damaging to the environment. We're planting almost 2 billion trees a year around the world. And we're doing that through many tree planting programs that simply don't work. In 2019 in Turkey, 11 million trees were planted in just one day. But many were planted at the wrong time and in the wrong place. And although the government denies it, the country's forestry union claims that 90% of the saplings died within months. Tree planting also requires way too much land and could potentially take away from land that we need to grow food and support existing ecosystems and habitats. And we're starting to do some frankly stupid things to find room for all the trees we need to plant. Like literally chopping down other trees so that we can plant new ones. Seriously, are we actually doing that? Crazy. Not to mention, we're screwing with biodiversity along the way. Most large-scale tree planting programs are monoculture plantations, meaning that only one or two types of trees are planted, species that are often not native to the area and fast-growing. These plantations disrupt natural ecosystems and often decrease biodiversity. For example, according to recent research, mass tree planting efforts in China and Brazil are responsible for actually degrading vast areas of land. And the legal loopholes don't help either. Tree plantations are technically classified as forests by the UN, so they get blindly pushed as solutions to reverse deforestation. You know what else qualifies as a forest? London. Seriously, it has enough trees to meet the legal UN definition. We pat ourselves on the back for replacing one forest with another forest. Problem fixed. This is causing complacency, which is another huge problem when it comes to the tree planting craze. All this work on one solution makes us think that we've solved the entire climate crisis, which is a whole world of wrong, because this crisis is complicated. And whether we like it or not, the solutions are complicated too. Planting trees can distract from the core issues of the climate crisis, like burning fossil fuels and the socio-economic pressures that led us here in the first place. Let's make one thing clear. Planting trees is not in itself a bad thing. There's actually a lot of evidence that when it's done properly, it works. In Brazil, 2.7 million native trees have been planted in this southern region. This region is home to vulnerable species like this little guy. Isn't he cute? These trees ended up creating forest corridors that helped tamarind populations recover. But you know why it worked in this case? because the trees planted were native to the land, which means that they were useful to the locals who built their lives around that resource. Consulting indigenous communities was crucial in the success of this project. But ironically, what's simpler than planting trees is, well, protecting trees. Letting forests grow back is not only cheap and easy, but also more effective at our ultimate goal, sucking carbon out of the atmosphere. Natural and biodiverse forests can store up to 40 times more carbon than plantations. Like a fine wine, trees only get better with age. They stand grand and majestic, witness to humanity's time here on Earth. They're also efficient beings, always working to make this planet a better place for us. So as far as this problem is concerned, maybe the answer isn't some radical human innovation, but maybe the best thing we can do is to simply get out the way and let nature do its thing.